the room has changed. It's all different. We've moved house! Escape. This episode has been a bit, I realize it's been a long time coming and it's very behind schedule. For the past while, there's just been general mayhem going on. We've moved house, I've moved jobs. It's all just been very up and down, and I haven't actually had much time to film and get footage together and edit things, but hopefully that will, you know, as things are settling down a bit, that will change going forward. We've also been to South Africa again. There'll be another little episode of that coming out hopefully soon, but in the meantime I have managed to cobble a few bits and pieces together, which I'll show you now. And we'll start with where we now live.
So I'm here in our garden, and it's quite cold. It's about 6 degrees today. And I thought, I was just kind of hanging out with the cats, and I thought it would be maybe a nice idea to take you inside and show us our house. Magellan, come on. Are you going to come? Come on.
It's Britain, so that's a van. This is our front door. There's the street for the car. That is our entrance hall. Carpet. Our front room that has a window looking out onto the street. We normally hang around here. There's the cat scratching post. This is just where we generally sit. It's quite small, even by English standards. It's got a few bits and pieces there, some books. Radiators are important. Keep the house warm.
And then these are the stairs. We'll go up there in a minute. This is our dining room, and our minister, one of the ministers of domestic affairs. Bookshelf, more books, painting, wine rack, currently empty. Another cat. This is Bridget's desk, where she normally works. Our kitchen. Give me an idea. We've got a built-in dishwasher. We'll come back to that. It's behind there. And then view past the empty cider bottles out into the garden. And we'll go back past the cat. Oh, hang on. Yes, downstairs bathroom, through here, shower, loo, bath, view to garden again. Books, very important. And let's go upstairs. Oh, that is my bag of work clothes, all my PPE waiting at the front door. At the top we turn right, this is the main bedroom with a view back onto the street again. There's the van from earlier, very important. Wardrobe, another little small ensuite bathroom. This painting we've had in our bedroom since we moved in together. Not this bedroom, of course, it's come with us. Books, always important. And this is our spare bedroom. We've got a mattress in here. We couldn't get the bed that I made up the stairs. Well, we could get it up the stairs, it just couldn't turn the corner at the top. A view out over the garden. There's the cat. That's Magellan. And these are sort of a view of the other gardens to either side. There's me. Don't know if you can see. up the stairs into the loft. This loft has been converted, so we've got a bit more extra space up here. This is my kind of little office-y place to sit and write and work. I no longer have a shed, which is very sad. So I've had to kind of move all my woodworking stuff in here. I've got a vacuum cleaner that sucks up all the wood chips and things. A few little bits and pieces. You might recognize the box from a previous video. And just kind of general storage cupboard. That actually all of that wood, that's actually another cupboard. So if anyone's looking for a wardrobe, don't buy one. We can we can do a special price. That's our old dishwasher that we just couldn't bring ourselves to get rid of, because the one downstairs that's actually built in is horrible and rubbish, and this one is really nice. So maybe one day when we move, we'll have our nice dishwasher back again. And there's just a couple of skylights, and yeah, there we are. I found that little cabinet, in a skip. So yeah, got it for free. Always a good one.
The house itself is set in the ancient cathedral town of Winchester, which is easily one of the most beautiful cities in the world. There's a house at the bottom of our road that was built in about 1453, I think, so before America was invented. And I've managed to put together some clips of us out and about and exploring, which I've set to appropriate music.
Winchester Cathedral, you're bringing me down. You stood and you watched as my baby left town. You could have done something, but you didn't try. You didn't do nothing, you let her walk by. Now everyone knows just how much I needed that gal. She wouldn't have gone far away if only you'd started ringing your bell. Winchester Cathedral, you're bringing me down. You stood and you watched as my baby left town.
I realize in hindsight, those clips all looked like they were taken all on the same day. I assure you they weren't. It's just Bridget standing next to a canal looking at ducks. It extends over some weeks. We just do spend a lot of time. Our walks do tend to have a certain duckish theme to them. The work that I'm now doing I still do go out a bit at night, though not nearly as much as I used to. I work for a big company that builds and maintains highways, and now I'll just show you a few bits and pieces that I've managed to collect together over the last few months.
Diary of a Highways England ecologist. Diary of a highway ecologist. So there you can see behind me all the traffic cones have gone out. And if we turn around the other way, that's where they end, at that sign. And I need to get to not that lighting mast, not that one, but that one, which is beyond the reach of the traffic cones. So because it's England, they insist on you working behind traffic cones because it's a first world country, but also because it's a first world country. The lorry that has extra traffic cones on it has gone to Tesco's because it's past 1 o'clock in the morning and Tesco's is still open. Welcome to the first world. Somewhere outside Cheveley. It's about, I don't know, about 10 o'clock, half past 10. Doing a nesting bird survey. The reason I'm here at night, obviously it's easier to see the birds in the day, but the reason I'm here at night is because that's when they can put out the traffic management, which is all the traffic cones. I don't know if you can see behind me there. Close off the road. Or in this case, close off a lane of the road so that I can get access to look at some trees, which I can't really see because it's dark.
I know this episode has been a little bit shorter than normal, I hope you'll be able to grit and bear it until the next one comes out, which hopefully will be a little bit sooner. Until then, take care. Goodbye.
Is made of bushes and a labyrinth is made of stone. What do you think, John?
I think it's amazing.